1,000 concussions occur in all levels of football. And 60% of these are from head-to-head collisions. In an impact lasting just 15 milliseconds, a player's head, on average, experiences almost 100 G's of force. And collisions on special teams can result in forces of up to 190 G's. In the NFL, the average speed of a head-to-head impact, the velocity of both heads combined, is 20 miles per hour, with the struck player's head decelerating 14 miles per hour. According to studies done by Sports Science's chief medical advisor, Dr. Basil Aish, this 15 millisecond impact is equivalent to getting smashed in the head with a sledgehammer. In the last 10 years, the average number of days a concussed player is out has more than doubled, and even improved helmet technology is only able to reduce an 80G impact to 40 Gs, still several times when an F-16 pilot experiences, and more than enough to cause a concussion or neck fracture. For Sports Science on ESPN, I'm John Brinkus.
We've heard so much recently on the danger of concussions in sports, but tonight a new kind of concern, a kind of head injury that is much less obvious than a concussion, but it can have equally serious ramifications for athletes old and young. Here's ABC's Paula Ferris.
Parents signing up their children for Pee Wee football, wrestling with a child's desire to play and their own growing worries.
Hopefully that won't be too much contact.
Daddy. Not long ago, it was the Thomas family signing up 9-year-old son Owen. He would go on to be a star all the way to captain of Penn's football team. But in 2010, Owen committed suicide.
Did you ever notice any concussion-like symptoms?
No, never even complained of a headache.
Any changes in his behavior?
No, we didn't.
Owen never had a documented concussion, but after his death, researchers examining his brain found CTE, or chronic traumatic encephalopathy, an Alzheimer's-like disease seen in retired NFL players. It's linked to symptoms like dementia, erratic behavior, and yes, suicide.
Part of the brainstem is missing.
Research shows the biggest risk in contact sports like football, soccer, and hockey might not be concussions, but so-called subconcussive blows, those repeated hits to the head that Owen and so many children reared on football experience.
There's not enough symptoms that the player can detect that there's been a concussion.
We have to make a move to take the head contact out of the game.
Never, ever come into your opponent with your head down.
And youth leagues are. Next month, Pop Warner will announce groundbreaking changes. Children will be trained to use their shoulders instead of their head for contact.
Good, heads are up.
A step forward, but for the Thomas family, it's too late.
My determination as I go through each day is that some good might come out of his death, that other people will learn from it.
Paula Ferris, ABC News, Allentown, Pennsylvania.
Part of the problem is that players may hesitate to report symptoms. They may believe their injuries are no big deal, or they'll try to tough it out and return to the game for their team. There may be pressure from parents, other adults, or other players to keep playing. Don't let your athlete convince you that they're just fine or that they can tough it out. Emphasize to athletes and parents that playing with a concussion is dangerous.
If a coach suspects a concussion in a young football player, it is critical that that player not return to play or practice.
If one of your players has a concussion, their brain needs time to heal.
A repeat concussion, one that occurs in a short time period before the brain recovers from the first, can be very dangerous, as it may slow recovery or increase the chances of long-term problems. It can even be fatal. Most people who suffer a concussion fully recover. However, returning to sports and other regular activities too quickly can add weeks or months to an individual's recovery time.
For boys and girls who are in school, concussions not only affect sports performance, they can affect school performance as well. Students may find they can't do their homework, they can't concentrate or study because it prolongs their symptoms, just like a premature return to sports.
Exercising or activities that involve concentration, such as studying, working on the computer, and playing video games, may cause concussion symptoms, such as headache or tiredness, to reappear or get worse. After a concussion, physical and cognitive activities, such as studying and learning, should be carefully managed and monitored by a healthcare professional.
Super Bowl winning safety Dave Durson took his own life, convinced that the despair he faced was caused in part by the damage he suffered on the football field. And as Sharon Alfonsi reports, he wanted other football players to think hard about the dangers they face.
He was exceptional, a four-time Pro Bowl safety, number 22, a two-time Super Bowl champ.
Through the first four, this one's for Giles, intercepted by Durson.
Teammates say Dave Durson was also exceptionally smart and kind, which is why they were shocked when last week the 50-year-old killed himself with a gunshot to the chest. He sent a text message to his ex-wife hours before.
And he told me he loved me very much, and he was truly sorry, and that he loved the kids, and that he felt he thinks there was something wrong with his brain on the left side, and for me to please get it to the NFL.
Durson asked his brain be examined for chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE, a degenerative disease often found in those with a history of concussions.
Football players are at a very high risk because they take, studies show, about 1,000 hits to the head each fall. At least 20 G's, which is like a small car crash. So essentially your brain actually starts falling apart. 10 or 20 years later, you start getting symptoms like memory problems and emotional problems, and they eventually lead to dementia.
Durson, family members say, recently started having vision problems and struggled with spelling and forming words. The All-Star knew of CTE. He served on the board that ruled on retired players' disability claims with the NFL.
David was a very loving, caring man, and he always thought of others before he thought of himself. Even in this moment, by him wanting his brain to be examined and treated, and so he could possibly help other football players in the future.
And there is so much to learn. The NFL only recently started investigating the impact of football on the brain after years of denying any problems, donating $1 million to the CTE Center at Boston University, where Durson's brain will be examined.
And this will no doubt stir a lot more investigation. Okay, Sharon, thanks very much.
know we get them frequently in cheerleading, football, of course, soccer, both girls and boys, pretty much contact sports.
So before the school year starts, all athletes are required to take the impact test, starting with the football players. The software tests memory and how fast your responses are. Then, if a student is hurt, they take the test again to compare the new results with the old. Educators say this will definitely help determine if a student is well enough to head back out onto the playing field.